I've been using the Peter Thomas Roth Pro Strength Retinoid Peptide Serum for 1 year. The results have been amazing, but I'm going to stop using it. Hi, my name is Lauren O'Connell, and my videos help you to stylize your perfect skincare wardrobe. Now, to get into this, let's just start off with, here is my skin with nothing on it, just my morning skincare. I have no lights behind me, just window, and I'm shooting on my iPhone. So this truly is my skin as is, no filters, no edits. Nothing crazy on this video. And you can see my skin. I'm 38 years old. I just turned 38. I have an emerging crow's feet here, which I'll address in just a minute. And I have some fine lines that appear underneath my eyes when I smile. So I did just do my new face morning routine on my face. And this is pretty much what I'm working with. Now, I have to say, for being 38 years old, I think my skin does look pretty good. My forehead is really smooth. I do not have any Botox, no fillers, nothing. Literally only use skincare and new face. And this I've been using for a year. I think it's done a great job keeping my skin as youthful as possible. Really, it has. I've used it every single night. I have tons of videos and follow-ups and follow-ups and follow-ups, so you can really see my journey with this product. A lot of people have been asking me lately, are you still using it? And I have to say, this is my last bottle. I literally just finished it. And I'm not going to use it anymore. And the reason is, honestly, and just being honest, I really can't afford it anymore. It's $110, which is very expensive for me. I'm a mom of two. We live on a single income. And oh, my voice just cracked when I said that. But we live on a single income. And you know, COVID hit us hard. My husband got a pretty drastic pay cut. Luckily, he didn't lose his job, but he did get a pay cut from his salary for a few months, and it really set us back. So, you know how I love to look at ingredients, and I mean, I do have a very, very comprehensive ingredients analysis, especially getting into that Grand Active Retinoid. And I thought to myself, there's gotta be other products out there that are going to give me as good of a result or a pretty good result, but not be as expensive. So I did some research and I decided to start using, I literally started it last night. It's the Mad Hippie Vitamin A Serum. Now this uses something called HPR as their retinol. HPR stands for Hydroxy Peanut Cologne Retinoate. And guess what? It is the same exact thing as the Grand Active Retinoid. This is $110, this is $32.99. This is also packed with tons of other great ingredients. I do have a lot of reviews on the Mad Hippie products, and for the most part, I absolutely love them. So HPR is the same as Grand Active Retinoid. The only difference I'm really seeing, and I need to do a little bit more research into it, it says that Mad Hippie uses 1 to 2%, and this is 10%. However, when I looked at the Peter Thomas Roth online, all of their clinical studies are using a 2%. And I've become such a cynic with marketing and PR and how things are portrayed versus what they actually are, that I need to do a little bit more research and find out what exactly is in this and how different are these two from each other. Because truly, I did love the results with this one. And if you can afford it and you want to use it, by all means, get it. But I have a feeling this one's going to be amazing too. So this is what I'm saying. It's a money thing for me. I feel like they're pretty similar. They might be almost exactly similar. I need to do a little bit more research into it. And in about 4 to 6 weeks, I will post my first follow-up, my first review of using this product and any changes I've seen, or I might not see any changes at all because they're so alike that it's almost as if my skin didn't notice a difference. Both of these ingredients, which really is the same ingredient, when you apply this type of retinol to your skin, your body immediately recognizes it. It doesn't need to go through any chemical reactions for it to be able to bind to the receptors within your skin and for that magic to start happening. It works the same way a prescription strength product would work. So I will keep you guys posted, but just wanted to give you an FYI. And if you're wondering what skincare I use in the evening, my evening skincare routine, by all means, check it out right here. I show you the products I use, the order I use them in, why I use them, and you know I only use products that are good for the skin.